The thing is, to be honest, you've done like gigs like that where everybody said, oh, fantastic, but yeah, now you've got to do better.
Hi everybody, this is Jay Rouette. Just want to give you a little information how we're controlling our pests this year in our high tunnel production. And because of the growing demand for more safer products and more sustainable agriculture, producing fruits and vegetables, we decided to use biological controls using predatory beneficial insects rather than conventional pesticides. Now under a protective culture system like the high tunnel here and greenhouses, we're growing zucchini, cucumbers, peppers, tomatoes, and in our other high tunnel we have strawberries. And there's going to be three major pests that we're going to be dealing with in the high tunnel or greenhouse production. And that's white flies, aphids, and two spotted spider mite. So the first predatory beneficial insect that we're going to talk about is dicyphus. Dicyphus is going to help in controlling white flies and partial control on mites and thrips as well. But our main concern is going to be controlling the white flies in the high tunnel. It's going to feed off the eggs and the larvae of the white fly, and it prefers living on mullein plants, so we'll have these mullein plants all season long. They've already been inoculated with the dicyphus. And they're pretty hard to see on the plant right now. They will thrive right on this plant, and the adults will actually be able to fly to the plants that are going to be infected with white flies. They will, again, feed on the eggs and the larvae of the white flies that are that possibly will infest the plants in the high tunnel. The next beneficial insect in the high tunnel we'll talk about is the colmani. The colmani is a parasitic wasp, and it feeds on aphids. And to start out the season, we start out these oat banker plants that are basically oats in the pot here, and we inoculate them with cherry oat aphids. And the cherry oat aphids only feed on monocots. They won't go on dicots or broadleaf. So we don't have to worry about them infecting or infesting any of our peppers, tomatoes, strawberries, cucumbers that we have behind us. So what we'll do is take the colmani here that come in this vial, sprinkle them on the oat banker plants here, and from there they will start colonizing on the cherry oat aphids and start reproducing, and we'll have a sustainable colony of the colmani throughout the season. From there, the adults will go out, and they can actually fly, so they'll fly out, and if there's any other aphids on peppers, which we have a big issue with greenhouse aphids on peppers, they will help control that population, and hopefully we won't have any issues with aphids on our peppers this year. Okay, so the next beneficial insect we're going to talk about is Encarsia formosa. This is another parasitic wasp, and this is another wasp that's going to help control white flies. And what it does is it will feed on actually lay eggs in the nymph stage of the white flies, and thus controlling the white fly population in the high tunnel. These do not, there's no sustainable life cycle for these in the high tunnel right now, so what we do is we get these cards that have the eggs there on the card, and they'll hatch from there. And what we'll do is we want to keep them out of direct sunlight, so about once a week we'll release half a dozen cards in here, half a dozen in the other high tunnel where we have our strawberries. And what we'll do is, so you want to keep them out of direct sunlight, so what we'll do is just take this and hook it on the plant like that, and those eggs will hatch and the adults will fly off and go looking for white flies and controlling them. Last one I want to talk about is permissiveness. Permissiveness is going to be a predator that goes after spider mites, which is going to be a big issue in here with strawberries. Spider mites love going after strawberries, especially in a protective culture like greenhouse or high tunnel. They're a very small insect. You can really only see them with a magnifying glass, so that's why they carry them in a vermiculite bottle, so it's easier to spread out. They do not fly, so that's why they carry them with a vermiculite, so we can spread them out on the base of the plant. And to do that, you just take the bottle and spread it lightly over the plant. And they will last for about 3 weeks, depending if there's any spider mites or any on there. So if there's no spider mites, then they will eventually die off. But all of these controls I'm talking about are a preventative program, so you want to start them in your high tunnel or greenhouse early on. It's not a cure. If you already have an infestation, you may have to use other options to controlling them. There may be a time when we have to do some other practices in controlling pests in here. We do have some options with other organic sprays, like an organic mustard meal, that will help control any aphids, mites, or wet flies that we have in here. And there's also another product, biological organic product called Grandevo, that works very well on controlling aphids, spider mites, and wet flies. So that's it for now. We're just gonna get this going. I'd like to thank Jim and Bob Dickman at Dickman Farms, especially Doug Mead at Dickman Farms for getting us started and educating us on biological controls and protective culture. So we'll keep you updated as the season goes, and hope we have a good season. Thanks.